Robert Ferguson, Ian Fine, Crystal Fisher, Daniel Fish.
Name after name.
David Fleming, Rudy Flores.
Hundreds of them, now a part of history at a pardon and parole board meeting on Friday.
527 inmates have been recommended to the governor for commutation. 462 inmates are scheduled to be released as a result of this.
The largest single-day commutation in U.S. history. That's what Governor Kevin Stitt is expecting come Monday.
Today, we are implementing the will of the people. I truly believe that.
Oklahoma moving the needle in criminal justice reform back in 2017 when voters approved State Question 780, making simple drug possession a misdemeanor, giving offenders already serving felony time for those crimes a chance at freedom. Then the bipartisan effort to pass House Bill 1269 this past legislative session, making that chance a reality.
There were so many different pieces of policy coming in, and on this, we all could sit together at the table and say, this matters.
I'm excited after doing the numbers. I will tell you at the end of the day, Oklahoma is no longer number one in the nation in incarceration.
Yes.
No longer.
And the state also expected to save over $11 million in average prison costs once those inmates are released.
This group of nonviolent offenders are just a part of this story. By the end of this year, we're anticipating we'll have about 2,000 empty beds in our system.
Amen.
Beds emptied and homes soon to be once again filled with loved ones who've been missed.
These are real lives, real people, with real families and with real friends, and they get to go home.